Okay, before we get going here, you're looking at a mind map of what we'll be covering in this tutorial. And it's very important to really master all these topics, because this is what makes you a good collar replacement specialist. Now, this will be part of the complete shirt making course, but you could make a living just doing cuff and collar replacement if you really don't want to get into putting in the months or the years to become a master shirt maker. So I've sort of developed an independent course where you could make a living, passive income or extra income, and keep your present job. But the question here is, why would they send you cuffs and collars? Well, a lot of it is they're frayed. And you can see this one here is frayed. It's been worn so many times. They say that the average shirt will last about 50 washings. And it just depends on how many times you wear them a week. You know, if you've only got three shirts and you got to wear them four or five times a week, it's not going to last very long. So again, they're all frayed. This is an end-to-end, and it's you can see where it's frayed on there. And we'll get into the concepts of some men don't like white. Wrinkled all the time, and most cleaners don't know how to handle it anyway, so you have a problem with that. This one here is stained on the edges, and on this particular one, we made it big. You'll see that most of these manufacturers usually put two button. They want to cater to small wrist and big wrist, but if you give us the exact size, we'll make it any size you want. Here's a Oxford. And again, it's frayed on the edges. This particular one was too narrow. The customer didn't like it. It was only like 2 1/4, so he wanted it to be 3 inches. So we made 3 inches, and we cut it from the shirt tail. Some of these cuffs can be so long that they're just too big for the customer, and they'll send them in, and we'll either cut them from the shirt tail, or we could possibly deconstruct this and make it smaller by just reshaping it, which we have done, a little bit more work. It is possible, and many reasons. This is a non-fusible, same way. It's all wrinkled, and it's had its day. This one here is stained. We'll show you all the techniques that it takes to satisfy your customer. Now, here's a cuff, French cuff, that the customer just got tired of wearing French cuffs, and so he wanted us to convert them to a barrel cuff. So normally what we normally do is we'll measure off and say he wants it 3 inches wide, and we'll make it 3 inches wide, and we'll go ahead and draw a line, put a seam allowance on that, and make them 3 inches. Well, we have to be careful here. Is that this button here is pretty close to the middle, and if it isn't, I would recommend you putting maybe a two-button hole. And in this particular case, we'd have to put buttonholes on both sides, because we'll have to make it a convertible and make it look balanced. But we would cut on here, and then I'll show you the technique of how to finish it. And so basically, that is why people send their cuffs in for replacement. And again, we'll get into the pattern making, the angle, the round. Here's a wider angle. Here's a real wide round. And here's a square. And when we get into the drafting, I'll show you how to make all these. The simplest way to work efficiently. And I'll show you how to use the templates that I'll provide a copy so that you can take your standard rectangle and you can go ahead and make them round, or you can make them angled, and it just saves you a lot of time. You become more efficient so you don't have to be scrapping. We're going to show you all the ins and outs of doing cuff replacement. We'll get into a lot of the topics you see here, the trimming, the pattern making, how to prepare the fabrics, the buttonholes, very important. Most home machines make lousy buttonholes, and you have to be careful when you cut them open. The costing, how much do you charge for the work? And when you take the cuffs off, yeah, there's a technique to removing them without tearing them. And we're going to show you all the ifs, buts, and ands. And most important is, when you're dealing with customers, what questions to ask them, because to a lot of them, this is brand new. They don't know the opportunities they have. For example, if they have a sleeve length of 35 and their present shirts are 34 and their cuff is 2.5 inches, you could make it 3.25 and give them a 35 inch sleeve length. So there's a lot of things that you can solve by talking to your customer, and this way they see you're providing them a good service and they become repeat customers, and that's the key, repeat. And this is an art. And in this course, the cuff and collar replacement specialist, if that's all you want to do, this is the course for you. Unfortunately, it's only part of the complete shirt making course.